Mexico are now back to normal operations. This after large crowds tried to make entry all at once on Sunday, causing disruptions at least three different border points. But while all eyes are on the southern U.S. border, that other border, the northern one, is facing its own set of immigration issues. CNN's Paulo Sandoval visited one country road in a northern border town that's creating tensions between the United States and Canada.
On a lonely, frozen stretch of upstate New York, a dead end. This is where the U.S. and Canada meet at a makeshift unauthorized crossing known as Roxham Road. Anyone who treks across the border here into Quebec is told by Canadian authorities they will be immediately arrested.
I have to advise you it's illegal to enter Canada here.
Right now you're under arrest for crossing the border of Canada.
It's illegal to enter Canada here. If you do so, you will be placed under arrest by the police.
But every day, a seemingly endless stream of asylum seekers intent on trying to find safe haven in yet another country cross the line anyway.
Come right in there. I'll take your baggage.
Warnings are everywhere on this road in Champlain, New York. They don't deter the stream of people, many of whom have cobbled together a way to get to Manhattan, then take a bus to a town 28 miles south of here, and then pay a driver to drop them off at this tiny corridor. They're unaware of what lies ahead and the cold they'll face along the way.
God bless you.
Okay, let me see about a jacket.
Some community members trying to help, providing them with warm clothes that they'll need.
It's okay, it's okay.
People from all over the world are crossing Roxham at historic rates. We met a family from Nigeria, a man from Russia.
No money, no money.
Thank you, thank you, yeah. Thank you.
And this South American mother, in tears,
porque llevo muchos días.
Tells me she's been traveling many days to get here.
El año pasado hice solicitud de visa.
Giovanna tells me she and her 23-year-old daughter were denied foreign visas last year when guerrillas in Colombia threatened to kill her. She says she was forced to close her business and flee. I feel I can have a better quality of life in Canada instead of remaining in the U.S., she told me before she stepped over the border.
Hola.
Hola.
¿Cómo estás?
After a brief detention, she'll likely be released to join fellow migrants who are learning the asylum process in Canada isn't easy either. These last few years have seen an influx in crossings that Canada is not prepared to handle. Simply securing appointments to obtain a work authorization can now take months or longer.
This individual crossed in February, and you're seeing that their date's actually February 11th, 2025, so 2 years.
About an hour north of the border.
Over here also.
Abdullah Daoud helps lead the refugee center in Montreal.
So these numbers are a dramatic increase from the numbers that we're used to seeing historically in Canada.
The nonprofit working with the Canadian government to help guide refugees through the asylum process.
December saw an increase from November. January saw an increase from December. February saw an increase from January.
Canadian government figures show a record 39,000 unauthorized entries into Quebec from the U.S. in 2022. Nearly all, according to experts, entered through Roxham Road. In January alone, crossings here neared 5,000. Compare that to just more than 2,300 a year before. U.S. and Canadian officials are discussing potential changes to the Safe Third Country Agreement. A loophole in that treaty is incentivizing migrants crossing from the U.S. to use Roxham Road.
The way to close Roxham Road is to renegotiate the Safe Third Country Agreement with the United States, which is something that we've been working on for many, many, many months now.
Separate from Roxham, an increased number of migrants from Mexico are making the perilous journey south over the snowy border. The U.S. Border Patrol sharing these images showing some groups with infants and children in the sub-zero temperatures. Mexican consular officials telling CNN they'll often fly to Canada and take their chances walking through frigid woods and farms.
An additional 25 agents being sent to the nearby Border Patrol sector to try to help them deal with that increased southbound flow of migrants. But important to remind viewers, Jake, that though the numbers that we're seeing here on the northern border pale when you compare it to the border some 2,000 miles from here, what you saw is certainly a reminder of the politics and perhaps most importantly, the people at play. Jake?
Paulo Sandoval.